త్రీ మంత్స్ ఎగో వెన్ ఐ వాచ్ ద ట్రైలర్, ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ యూ మేడ్ మీ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఎ డిఫరెంట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎమోషన్. ఐ ఫెల్ట్ లైక్ యు నో వాచింగ్ I don't know, it's not exaggeration actually. It's like watching Jim Caviezel, you know, from Passion of the Christ. Some wow. That kind of feels you are given. So what exactly, you know, there are a lot of survival thrillers, there are a lot of survival and rescue thrillers. And recently Malayalam industry has given Manjimal Boys as well. So what exactly made you pick this film, sir? Because in almost all the survival thrillers, it will be like you will be lost somewhere, maybe cheated or something, you will be lost somewhere. And finally, how you reach your destination or what happens to you is going to be a simple story actually. So what made you, because in all survival thrillers the element is going to be the same actually, so what is that so different, or what is that, you know, what made you actually pick Najib's life, you know, to be translated to the silver screen?
So like you rightly said, survival in itself is a very universal theme, and what appeals to our conscience about survival is because it speaks on the resilience of the human spirit. Whatever circumstances you are faced with, however big the challenges are, how unfavorable the odds are, deep down the human mind has this amazing resilience, this strength to actually be able to overcome all that. So that is a universal theme that in any adaptation, any form, it always appeals to you. You're right, you know, survival thrillers, survival adventures, survival films will all have a common thread running through them. But this film is not just about survival, you know. It's a very unique, deeply meditative character study as well. Because there is this man who's taken from a world full of water. So Najib, before going to the deserts, he was a freediving sand miner. In the early 90s, people used to dive down into the riverbed and take sand for construction. Now it is banned. It is illegal. You can't do that now. But those days, it was a flourishing industry. So that was his job. That was what he used to do. And people who used to do that job, their days are like 4 to 6 hours, they're underwater. So their world is full of water. And then he lands up where even the air has no moisture. He's not given water to drink. He's not given water to wash himself. There is no water, you know. Slowly, he has no one to speak his language to. Because two people who he sees, they don't know his language. He doesn't know their language. Slowly he stops speaking. He begins to lose the ability to articulate. He can no longer form a sentence. And then 3 years later, when you see the person in the film, you realize that he's actually now probably more animal than human. Because for 3 years, he's only been with the animals. He's only interacted with them. He's only lived with them. The only living creatures he's been speaking to are the animals, the goats and the camels. So that metamorphosis is, I think, very unique to Najib's story. I don't think there has been another story said in the world where a human mind and a human body goes through that kind of a physical, physiological, mental and emotional metamorphosis through the character arc. So that was very interesting for me.
Sir, but while doing the physical transformation, you know, there's just a lot of star heroes and star heroines. Whenever they're putting on weight and losing weight, they're actually going through a lot of health complications. So, but what made you take the risk and, you know, take up 31 kilos, losing, putting on weight, gaining weight, and again losing 31 kilos is no joke, actually.
No, so it's not a joke.
Yeah, didn't you worry about the, you know, health complications that might arise?
Yeah, I did. See, in 2009, when Blessy Sir offered me the film, I was still a very young actor, okay? Very young actor trying to find my space in the industry. I was doing fairly well for myself, but still I was trying to find my space in the industry. And Blessy Sir was the most coveted director in Malayalam industry. He even today is. Every actor, every actress wants to do that one Blessy film at least. He's like that to us. I don't know if you've seen his other films. If you haven't, you should. Okay, you should see all his films. So at that point in time, a director known for eliciting fantastic performances from great legendary actors, like his first film was with Mammukka, second film was with Mammukka again, then he did films with Mohanlal sir. All of them have, in fact, even some of Mammootty sir's and Mohanlal sir's best performances are in recent history is from Blessy films. So such a filmmaker, for his dream film, for the most complex character that he has ever created or he has ever adapted, comes to a young actor and tells me, I want you to do this. So immediately I know the whole industry is jealous of me. I would be jealous of somebody who got this opportunity to do Najib. So what is the one thing that I should promise myself? That I will not let anyone see the film and say, he could have tried more. He could have put in some more effort. Either I do the film or I don't do the film. I decided to do the film. When I do something, I do it 120%. So,
sir, what is the source of inspiration, sir, to accepting these kind of scripts?
So, basically, it's a deep love of cinema. Because I don't know anything else in life. I'm 12th standard pass, actually. No other further qualification. I know no other job. If I don't have films, there is no company that will hire me because I have no qualification. Okay, so my whole life is about cinema only. I have a deep love of cinema. Secondly, it's a very, very inspiring true story, you know, and wonderfully adapted for the screen by Blessy Sir. And thirdly, like I said, the most coveted, the highest paid director of Malayalam industry is telling you that for the next 16 years, whatever happens, I'm going to be behind this one film because this is my dream film. And he's chosen you. He's picked you for the main responsibility of that vision. So what further inspiration do you need? You know, that's very big inspiration, actually.
Sir, what would be the major changes to observe yourself after completion of this journey?
Sir, when I said yes to the film, I was not married, I was not a father, I had not turned producer, I had not turned director, I had not turned distributor. I was, 25 years old, 24 years old, you know. So life has changed. For the past so many years, so many phases of my life I have traversed through, and the one constant is, Aadijeevitham is happening. Aadijeevitham film is happening. So I keep saying, you know, on the 28th of March, for me it is not a film release. It is like one big chapter of my life culminating. So let's see.
Sir, can we expect the film to go to any, you know, Oscars and or some other bigger platforms where you can like bring us one more award? Because you already have A. Rahman sir and Rasul Pookutty, the two Oscar winners.
Sir, we really hope so. We really hope that, of course, I mean, going to the Academy, vying for an Academy Award and all, also entails a lot of other things, like a very big campaign. We have to now set up a campaign for the film, etc. In all honesty, all the money we have put into making the film. That is the truth. So now, hopefully, when the film releases, some big studio or somebody will see the film and tell us, Ravi Garu, somebody will tell us, sir, we have to do a proper Los Angeles campaign, and maybe Jimmy can help us. I'm being very honest here. This is a very, very expensive film. For Malayalam, for Telugu, it's okay. For Malayalam, it's a very, very expensive film. In fact, probably the most expensive film ever made in Malayalam. So we really don't have any more money.
Maybe, sir, Maitri Ravi sir will put in. We'll see.
Yeah, all hopes on Ravi sir.
Sir, I'd like to talk to Blessy sir. Sir, actually, you know, you selected a finest actor and all, but when we are talking about budgets, the moment you see the trailer, you feel like, okay, this is all shot in the desert. So why did it actually need, you know, 80 crore budget to be put in? Is it like you spent more on the quality sound, or is it because of the visuals, or you had you used any VFX?
Actually, we think to start the desert in Rajasthan, but we can't found any deep desert there, and also the gods are very different in Arabian gods and Indian gods are like that. So many hurdles was there, and also in 2018 money value for US dollar was only 60 rupees, I think in that was only in 16, now is 82 83 85, like that. So that fluctuation is also affected, and we spend a lot of money for the COVID situations and all. And also we found very beautiful location in, we shot in desert around 150 days. So that all are very expensive. And you know, Mr. A. R. Rahman, Rasul Pookutty, all technicians are very good technician in India itself. So.
Understood, sir. Sir, Ravi, sir. సార్, మీరు ఆల్రెడీ ఇప్పుడు గోట్ లైఫ్ ఒక మలయాళం సినిమా వస్తుంది, అగైన్ ఇన్ ఏప్రిల్లో ఐ థింక్ యువర్ రిలీజింగ్ మంజుమెల్ బాయ్స్ యాజ్ వెల్.
అది ఇంకా డేట్ అనుకోలేదు సార్. అది
అది కూడా సేమ్ సర్వైవల్ అండ్ రెస్క్యూర్ థ్రిల్లర్. యువర్ ఫ్యాన్ ఆఫ్ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ జోనర్ సార్?
సార్, వీఆర్ బేసికలీ ఫ్యాన్ ఆఫ్ మలయాళం ఫిలిమ్స్ అండ్ అంటే కంటెంట్ రిచ్ ఫిలిమ్స్ అండి. నాట్ నెసర్లీ ఇది ఇదే ఇదే అని చెప్పకూడదేమో, కానీ ఇదైతే అందరికీ నచ్చేది ఏంటి అంటే నిజంగానే కంటెంట్ రిచ్ ఫిలిమ్స్ దట్ కమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ మలయాళం ఇండస్ట్రీ అనేది ఒక ఓపెన్ ఫ్యాక్టే. వీ లవ్ దోస్ ఫిలిమ్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో మంజుమల్ బాయ్స్ కూడా వీఆర్ ట్రయింగ్ ఫర్ దట్ ఫిలిమ్ సిన్స్ ఎ లాంగ్ టైమ్ అండ్ అగైన్ హోప్ఫుల్లీ వీ మే డూ దట్ అండ్ దిస్ ఫిలిం రన్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ సఫిషియెంట్గా సరిపోయినాకే దెన్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు రిలీజ్ ద థింగ్.
పృథ్వీరాజ్ గారితో ఏమైనా స్టాండ్ అలోన్ ఫిల్మ్ ఏమైనా ప్లాన్ చేస్తున్నారు సార్?
డెఫినెట్గా సార్, ఆ ఛాన్స్ రావాలి అనేసి షూర్ షాట్. యు నో వన్ థింగ్, వీ హ్యావ్ మిస్ హిమ్ ఇన్ సమ్ వెరీ వెరీ బిగ్ ఫిలిం, బట్ ద థింగ్ ఈస్ ఓకే. అండ్ అగైన్ వీ యూస్ టు అప్రోచ్ హిమ్, అంటే పృథ్వీరాజ్ గారు సి, అంటే ఆయన గురించి మనం కొత్తగా చెప్పుకునేది ఏమి లేదు. ఎన్ని ఎన్నిసార్లు చాలా చాలా ఆటలు ఉన్నాయి సార్, ట్రై చేస్తాను.
మిస్డ్ ఫిల్మ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు ఆస్క్ ఎర్లియర్, ఐ వాంటెడ్ టు ఆస్క్ యాక్చువల్లీ. ఐ థింక్ యూ
అది రిలీజ్ అయిపోయింది
సార్. ఆస్క్డ్ యూ ఫర్ సైరా, దెన్ యూ సెడ్ యువర్ షూటింగ్ ఆడుకలం. ఐ థింక్ అగైన్ దే అప్రోచ్ యూ ఫర్ గాడ్ ఫాదర్ అగైన్ యూ సెడ్
ఫర్. ఐ వాస్ వెరీ వరీడ్ దట్ చిరంజీవి సార్ విల్ థింక్ ఐ యామ్ లయింగ్, బికాజ్ ఐ కీప్ టెల్ రిపీటింగ్ ది స్టోరీ. యు నో ఇన్ 2017 ఆర్ 18 ఐ థింక్ చిరంజీవి సార్ త్రూ సుహాసిని మ్యామ్, మణిరత్నం సార్ వైఫ్ సుహాసిని మ్యామ్, had gotten in touch with me to play a role in Saira Narasimha Reddy. And I was very flattered because Chiranjeevi sir thinking of me for a big role is for me like a big certificate, you know. So that time I told him, really sorry sir, you know, I would love to have worked with you, but I've just committed to this, beginning to shoot this film that I've been waiting for 10 years. So I have to grow my beard and lose weight and all that. And sir told me no problem and he understood. I think 4 years later when I had become a director, I had directed one film and that film released and it had become a hit in Kerala. Chiranjeevi sir had bought the rights to that film. And also Saira Narasimha Reddy was releasing. So for the Kerala event of Saira Narasimha Reddy, when Chiranjeevi sir came, I was the chief guest for the event. So at that time, Chiranjeevi sir's team was pitching the idea, asking me, why don't you think of directing Lucifer in Telugu also? Then I'm telling Chiranjeevi sir, sir, I would have loved to, sir, but unfortunately there's this big film that I'm doing, sir, for which I have to grow my beard, I have to look. And he's like, hey, 4 years ago you said the same story that actually happened. And I had forgotten that I had told that same excuse. But I hope Chiranjeevi sir's team has conveyed it as actually true. But no, Chiranjeevi sir actually, you know, he's such a sweet person. He messages me. He once in a while and you know he keeps in touch, so does Ram, and he messaged me the day Godfather released and I'm hoping someday I'll be able to work with him. Yeah,
good luck sir, all the best for that.
Thank you so much.
Prithviraj here. Here center.
Where? Center. Okay, yeah, hi.
I'm Anjali from TFPC.
Hello.
I have two questions for you.
Okay.
First one is The Goat Life. So as you say, it's a true story and every breath is very important.
Yeah.
So me Telugu you can understand, sir?
I'm beginning to understand.
As you say that so much things are changed in your life during this movie shooting, so the most painful struggle of film industry ante em cheptaru mee life lo
of the film industry?
Yeah, in your journey.
I have had no struggle, madam. The most painful struggle for the film industry are the people waiting outside to get in, you know, waiting for that first opportunity. I know I'm very lucky. I have got my first opportunity because my father was a famous actor, not because I was very talented and all, you know.
Okay.
Like I'm a nepo kid. Yeah.
Generally no one is using that nepo kid.
Yeah,
but you are saying that nepo kid.
That's a terminology that it's now coined. No, I also don't, but the fact is that my first film I got because my father was a famous actor only. But I got only my first film because my father was a famous actor.
But
after that, it is my hard work.
yeah, that's yeah. True. And my second question is all about Salar, Prabhas Garu.
Uh-huh.
So everyone says that Prabhas Garu gives a very good food to everyone.
Yeah.
So you're bonding with him.
I'm anyone? Going, no, in 2 hours I'll be there having food with him.
Any particular item?
I'm in Hyderabad, then definitely I'll be hanging out with him only. So evening I'm going there.
Oh, party, sir.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, then. And all the best for the movie, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Prithvi garu. whenever you felt that while doing this kind of roles, whenever you felt that why I would choose this role, so much pain is there, a lot of changes are there, your look is very painful, look is there. Whenever you felt that why would I wouldn't have choose this role?
Never, sir. I have, in the beginning few months, I questioned why this role chose me. I have never questioned why did I choose this role, because it's a privilege for an actor, you know. You don't get films and roles like this. Even if you could say, I've done 100, 120 films now as an actor. I'm directing my third film, I've produced, I don't know, 10, 11 films. But films like these don't happen very often. Like once in a lifetime film. So when if you get an opportunity as an artist, forget as an actor, as an artist, any craft, to be involved with a piece of cinema like this, then you don't question that. I never questioned it. But both of us had that moment of fear when we had to stop shoot in 2020 following the pandemic. Because already we had invested so much effort, so many years of struggle. I had lost more than one third of my body weight, and we had to stop shoot, and we didn't know if we were ever going to be able to restart. But we could, and here we are. So,
are there any satires or criticism about the Arab sheikhs or Arab countries?
So that one very important thing I want to tell you about this film is that this is not about going to another country and getting stuck. The actual core element of the story can happen to anybody, anywhere. It's about forceful confinement. It's about forced labor. It's about taking away a man's identity from him. So that can happen to anyone, anywhere, if you are unfortunate enough to be going through those circumstances. In Najib's story, it involved him going to the Gulf. It needn't be that it has to happen in the Gulf. It can happen anywhere in the world.
Okay, sir. All the best.
Thank you.
Prithviraj, sir.
Prithviraj, sir.
Yes.
The trailer is very heart-wrenching and emotional story.
Sorry?
Trailer is looking very heart-wrenching and emotional journey.
Thank you.
So, did you feel ever the scene acting this film? So, very claustrophobic for audience to feel that your acting is very poignant. So, taking the another world, the audience is very impact of this film.
I think I understood your question. So, I'm going to answer to the question that I understood. Okay. It's a very intense film. It's a very intense film. This is not a film where you have a separate comedy track for relief and all. But I think cinema has generally moved on from that, no? I don't think now, even for a commercial film, I remember even for my own films, like in early 2000s and all, we used to read a script and then it'll be like, oh, scene 23, comedy. Scene 24, next. Eh? So then the comedy scene would be written later by the artist also involving it, because that scene would have no relationship with the rest of the plot. That is now not there in any film, I think. Anyway, there is no like relief track to make the audience feel good about themselves, etc. But this is a film where I don't think you would want to take your eyes off the screen, because basically the book is a very, very detailed 43 chapter long documentation of what this man went through. And even the book, that big book, if you ever read the English version at least, it'll be very difficult for you to put the book down. It's very, very difficult. You talk to people who have read R.D. Jeevitham, 99 out of 100 people will tell you, I started and I didn't stop till I finished. It's actually very difficult to put the book down. That big book itself is like that. And the film is a concentrated version of that book. So I don't think you'll ever want to, you know, want the story to go away. I think you'll want to stay in the intensity. I think you'll, that's what I said. It's a very deeply meditative character study. You'll just want to keep traveling with this character. And that is because of the way he has made the film. Okay. I mean, an actor, since I am a director also, it'll sound very immodest and not nice in me saying this. But since I'm an actor also, I think I can say, whatever an actor does, we are limited by our directors. So only a great director can make an actor look good.
There is a lot of survival thrillers in our Bollywood or Tollywood or Hollywood. So you see the Life of Pi book is also converted to silver screen. So the movie also survival in a sea. Your movie also same thing to survival thing.
I think I already answered that question, the gentleman's question. So yeah.
Prithviraj sir. Yeah.
Yes.
So, Aadu Jeevitham is the best seller in the Malayalam.
Yes.
So, what is the need of telling on silver screen? What is the moral of the movie to tell the audience?
Moral?
Yeah.
It is this, sir. It is this that, you know, like yesterday, we had this wonderful program in Cochin. where as part of, as a tribute to the, I mean, as part of the promotion, we were paying a tribute to 30-odd survivors, people who have survived very difficult circumstances in life. So all of them actually shared their stories with us during the program. And one thing that struck us that Blessy Sir actually rightly said during the program was that we are going through a time and phase where I think in general, the human spirit and the strength of the human mind is becoming very fragile. We read so many sad stories, you know, of like somebody fell in love and couldn't get married and so they suicided. You know, so many stories of people giving up on life. I think in a world like that, in circumstances like that, a story like Najib's is the ultimate beacon of inspiration. What Najib fought through, what Najib survived, you know, if he can do that, and this is not fiction, this is a real life, that man is there, he's alive and well. If he can do that, one 10 standard fail, one love failure and all is nothing. You know? So that is the biggest lesson.
Sir, when you stuck in the desert at the COVID period, what was going in your mind?
Hunger, sir, hunger. I was always hungry. I was not eating food only. Because I had to be like this, no? Everybody was eating biryani and all, nothing for me, actually.
Prithviraj, sir, here. Good to see you. There is a film called Castaway.
Yes.
Did you watch that film?
Yeah, many times.
Till the date, that was my favorite film.
Yeah.
I hope 28th March, this is my favorite, I hope.
Thank you so much, thank you so much.
It's what would you say about Castaway and The Goat Life, Aadu Jeevitham?
Yeah, so like he asked, no, I mean, they are both survival stories of people having to fight circumstances, fight solitude and hold on to sanity and survive. The difference is the character metamorphosis, I said, you know. It is one thing being alone, talking to a volleyball. It's one thing being so desperate in your solitude that you subconsciously try and be one among the animals so that you feel like you are in a society. You know? And that's a very interesting character arc. I don't know if there is any other story that speaks of such a metamorphosis.
Have you adopted any characteristic transformations from that character, Castaway character?
No. So, I mean, I used to Google every possible actor's transformation to see what did each person do. Like, what did Christian Bale do for Machinist and what did Tom Hanks do for Castaway? What did Vikram Sir do for I? You know, I. Yeah. All these I used to, Vikram Sir, then I could speak directly also. But the thing is, no, I mean, you can't adopt what somebody else did because your body might not respond to it. So, ultimately, my transformation was based on literally not eating, which means fasting. So I used to fast. I used to fast for sometimes up to 72 hours. I will not recommend that to anyone. I know that there are studies that say fasting is very beneficial for your. But I'm not an expert. So please consult a doctor and all before you do it. I had a doctor. I had a doctor, a nutritionist, a trainer, everyone taking care of me.
Actually, IPL season is running in.
Yes.
What's your favorite IPL team?
You know, many people have asked me this, but unfortunately, I think I'm very old generation. I'm still yet to come fully in terms with franchise cricket. Like, because I like Dhoni, I'll support CSK, but I like Kohli also. So when CSK is playing RCB, I don't know who to support, you know. Yeah, but I like international cricket. I'll support India. Yeah.
Okay. Sir, Prithvi, sir.
One last question, please. Yes. Yeah.
Sir. Before Bahubali, we don't know the term of the Pan-Indian release. Mm. But after the Bahubali, the doors open for the Telugu release. And after the KGF, the Kannada doors are open. And do you feel that this is the one film that opened the doors for the Malayalam industry to think big, to reach wider audience?
Sir, actually, you know, Bahubali is that singular phenomenon that got all of us talking. But I think it'll always have to be a process. I don't think that one film can actually make a change. When Bahubali 1 happened, all of us thought it is once in a lifetime. It'll never repeat itself. Then Bahubali 2 happened. So then we thought it is only Bahubali franchise that can do this. Then KGF happened. So it'll have to be a continuous process for cinema to grow beyond its own boundaries. So now Manjimal Boys has happened. It has found widespread acceptance in multiple states. Premalu has found a big acceptance in multiple states theatrically. So maybe Aadijeevitham will follow it up. The next Malayalam film will follow it up. So it will have to be a slow process. At least today we are in a position where I'm sitting with Ravi Garu and Maitri is presenting my film. I have to tell you, 5 years ago, when a Malayalam film released, if you ask me who's distributing your film in Hyderabad, I wouldn't know. I really wouldn't know, because our systems, our networks were like that. We used to sublet, we used to give rest of India to one person. He used to then give it to different people. Hyderabad city, one person. Vizag, another person. It was like that. And it'll be like two screens here, one screen in Vizag. So 5 years ago, I'm not talking about 25 years ago. 5 years ago, if you had asked me which theater in Hyderabad city is your film playing, I wouldn't know. Today, I can give you the whole theater list because Ravi Garu is taking care of me. So,
sir, one more question to you. As an actor, also director, and from the 16 years, you're on board for this film. But as an audience, I love the one song, that hope. And whatever happens in our life, we have always on the hope. But what is the hope as an actor you have, and what is the hope you have as a director to motivate, to bring to you as an audience?
So right now, my only hope is that 28, this film is a super hit. That is my only hope, actually. Sir, Goat, actually, the name of the book and the film in Malayalam is Aadijeevitham, which literally translates to goat life. When you translate it word by word, it means goat life. But we found it very, very charming, for lack of a better word, that the Gen Z New Age English lingo, Goat is also an acronym for greatest of all time, you know. So if you want to read it as the greatest of all time life, I think it's quite plausible, because I truly believe Najib Mohammed's life is one of the greatest of all time lives.
Wow, amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much, media friends, for this.
Yeah, he was asking me, sure. He was with us for the promotions yesterday in Cochin. We'll bring him. Najibuka, we'll definitely bring, yeah.
Okay, soon Najib gar kuda join avabothunnaru anamata promotions ki. Thank you so much, media friends, and thank you so much, Prithviraj sir, and Blessy sir, and Jimmy sir for joining us. And yes, mark the date, guys, March 28th in theaters, The Goat Life. Oka beautiful experience ni, emotion ni manaku andinchadaniki vachestundi. See you all in theaters. Thank you, everybody.